What's going on? This is Crazy Russian 86 here. So there's somebody who wrote me a comment saying, like, why would you want to pay for somebody else's kids? Well, here is what I have to say. And why do I say that I don't have that much choice and I would rather just, like, choose that versus, like, dealing with other bitches and shit? Because let me tell you something. In this fucked up society, people tell you how to act, how to be. You can't just be yourself and do whatever the fuck you want. People judge you, people think wrong things about you because not everybody thinks the same. Let's start there. So, if you weird, if you creepy, if you're not like everybody else, nobody, no bitches wanna fuck you. And if they do wanna fuck you, then you know, they treat you like a subhuman, they wanna put you down, right? And they're gonna tell you what to do, how to live your life and shit like that. Why do I need that? I would rather be on my own, right? Because all I need from women is fucking pussy and entertainment. This is what women are for, okay? This is the utility of the woman, okay? So, if you have a single mom, right? She, you know, she may cost more, I agree, and that's kind of annoying. But you know what? I would rather just work myself to death and make money. So then I can get piece of ass. And I would rather pay for fucking somebody else's kids than deal with a bitch who would tell me how to live my life, who would tell me shit, who would fucking drop me in a heartbeat because she's young and good looking and she can get a better man with me. Now, the single mom, they're like leftovers. And because beggars are not choosers, and you know, it's not like I have a lot of choice, you know. I just don't have a lot of choice in life. That's why I just settling, because I don't give a fuck. And besides, in my situation, it's like, you know, it's just like personality factor too. You have to, like, find a woman whom you will be compatible with, whom you will get along, you know? And that's another thing, like, sometimes it just happens that way when you find somebody you can get along with, and that happened to be a single mom, so hey, fuck it, you know? If you get along with a woman like that and you have money, that's that. Of course, like, fucking prostitutes can be cheaper because you can find the crack whore for fucking 20-30 bucks. If you know somebody who can fly, supply you whores, you can pay the nigga for like 10-15 bucks, and then for 40-50 bucks you can bust a nut, okay? Sure, it's cheaper than, like, you know, supporting somebody else's kids, so. But at the same time, there is no future in it, because, you know, with a single mom, if she is not that old, maybe you can have kids down the road, and then there is this companionship factor, you know, things like that, you know. And with a hooker, it's convenient because you can treat her as a piece of meat, and you don't give a shit about her, and you're gonna get the pussy out of here, and that's all good, you know, but at the same time, that's like temporary, you know. Of course, it's like, it makes my ego, like, it makes me feel better about myself, because I'm like, hell yeah, I got some ass, hell yeah, I'm got some ass, and you know, and that's really a good feeling, if you can get pussy fast without, like, dealing with so much bullshit and all these fucking games. Because let me tell you something, all these bitches, you know, they just, like, play games and shit. At first, they're like, they're into you, but then you say something, it's just like, whoa, you know. It's just like, if you're different, if you don't act right, if you have problems, why women want to deal with you? Most of them, they just don't. So it's like, it's the thing of not having much choice in life. Besides, like, some bitches, they look at me like, I'm a small guy, you know, like, why should they choose a guy like me over the bigger guy? Because if the guy is big, he can fuck somebody up, he can hurt somebody, you know. But me, like, I'm a small guy, so it's like, you know, I need to kiss ass and get the power, you know, before I can actually just, like, show off and say, like, I'm the best and you all need to suck my dick and do what I tell you. Because I can't attack that way, because then the people gonna tell me, like, who are you to tell me what to do? Look at yourself, motherfucker. Because these shit people are bigger, better and stronger than me. So I need to kiss their ass in order to just basically survive, because I'm not the biggest, baddest and strongest man. And of course, bitches, they gonna choose as biggest and better and strongest man over me. Besides, here is the third thing about me, is that quite honestly, for a lot of these bitches, I don't have no feelings for, you know, like, prostitutes, you don't care, you know, you just treat them as a piece of meat, as a commodity and stuff. But I know the normal woman, you cannot treat that way. And I, you know, I know that because, like, I had friends in Russia who are girls, I had people who've been in relationship and stuff, you know. So I know that normal woman, you cannot treat them as a piece of meat. And some of them, if they have boyfriends, they're not going to go out with you like that unless they broke up or something happens, you know. So, and besides, women have standards. I'm not saying that all the single moms, they don't have standards, but single moms, because of their situation and everything, they just can drop their standards and say, hey, this man, he works, he tries hard. He makes some money, here I am struggling by myself. So, and think about it, if, like, you know, if she makes certain amount of money, I can make double that, I can take care of it, and then I know that I get pussy, you know, and that's like deserved. That's like easier way, you know. In a way it's easier, because you may spend more money on one hand, but on the other hand, you pretty much don't have to deal with all this extra stuff which can come, you know. Like, it's easy, it's less requirements. All you need to do is just go to work and make money and do what you can, and they just like gonna be, that's okay, he's not cheating on me, he's bringing money, hell with it, right? Versus other women, they may just like tell you shit and try to change, and they say, why should I deal with this guy if I can get somebody is better and bigger and stronger and everything? Like, why am I wasting with this guy who doesn't know how to deal with people, talk to people, or who has like personality issues? Like, why should I deal with that fuck? Why should I deal with that little fuck if I can get myself somebody bigger and better and more fun? Things like that, you know. That's why for the man like me, it's actually a wise decision to date a single mom. No matter how I'm looking at it. Yes, of course, it costs money, and that's kind of sucks, because it would be nice to get to have more money. But at the same time, money is not everything, because like people used to tell me, when you die, you're not gonna take your money with you. Money is only good while you're alive, so, and sometimes it's also about quality of life. And I can tell you that in the last couple of years, in some ways, like, my living condition and quality of life improved. Because when I was like younger, in my 20s, I used to live in the room, in the house. I was not making anything. I was angry, drunk, high. I was not dressing well. And I was just like, I just didn't give a fuck, you know, like, all I cared about, I was just like on the survival mode. All I cared about was just get this itty bitty money, like myself in the room, get some pussy, and that's it. Like, I didn't care about nothing else. I was like, I'm on survival mode right now. But, you know, now I'm, you know, already in my 30s and stuff, and it's, you know, it's just different time. It's time to have a family, have kids. Because if not, I would just too old and miserable, you know. Like, when you're in your 20s, you don't give a fuck. You just get drunk, get high, get some pussy, and you just like do whatever the fuck you want. But when you get older, you cannot have the same mindset, because it's like, you know, you're too old for certain types of activities. And besides, if you don't have anybody when you're old and miserable, and you die in pain. So that's just not a good end of life. So that's why, you know, I just go for what it is easier and more convenient for me, based on the circumstances and I'm down and personality I have. So I hope that does answer your question. So, and I hope you enjoy my video. All the best to you guys. Peace out. Later.